Alright, took a lunch break, back at it. What I could find right now. I didn't have my 24 millimeter deep socket. The only reason why I was able to take it off is because it was so bad they ate it off, and then they even ate away at these chips. Now one of these right here is from, it's still stuck in there, and then the other piece is right here, still stuck in there, but now this whole piece has been chewed away. So chewed a little bit right here. No, wait, that's my pliers. Where's that red one? They didn't chew that. This is where they chewed. You see, they, really liked it. Shit. Rodent resistant, huh? So. Going back at it. Tighten the connector. Now I gotta feed the wire again. Connector. the connector. Use that to pull it back up into place onto its bracket, original bracket. Now that it's lined up. Pliers. Work it from the bottom. And it's in place. So, I can move the clip. Make sure it's in there. It's in there. I don't want that coming loose. In case I ever have to disconnect it. Break these O-rings in any way, take care of them, and go back.
Generally, just as easy.
Clip.
little bit of lube.
Make sure clip like that. So they'll be going in this way. Make sure they're also seated to when they clip each side. And these center tabs right here.
Be doing a voiceover. So many people.
Anybody's talking.
Lovely fiance Janelle's right in the background watching this.
The director.
In some parts. There's a blooper. So, to make this easy on myself, I'm just going to remove that one. Like so. Wiggling slightly. So you get it seated. You don't want to just force it straight in, you'll risk incorrectly seating. Risk incorrectly seating the O-rings, the premium offset. Downward pressure. Placing in the second. And you can kind of see the hole behind it on the back side. Again, you just want to start it with your fingers. You can come back and tighten it. Here's my calibrated elbow. I do a lot of work with wrenches, so I get pretty good at it. Other people might need a torque wrench. Basically, you just don't want to over-tighten it and strip out your aluminum threads with the steel screw. Now I'm done with that. Done with the fuel rail. I'm going to be reattaching this device. Ensuring that the clip is realigned. So, seating it, now I'm going to test the pressure, check for leaks after replacing the lock. And I'll be replacing the fuse. I'm going to test the fuel pump, replace the fuse, reattach the battery cable. Supposed to be sitting like that. Alright. So, fuel, disconnect the battery, pressure in the system, no leaks. It's kind of windy where I'm at right now. I'm keeping my shoes around. So, let's see if I can turn this straight. Well, I can't really turn straight right now. There's no wind. Now that it popped holes in all my other ones, so don't do what I just did. parts. It's been secured. Then reattach the fuel line. Everything's been done down here. Now the next step would be to clean off this running gasket. Now, to be honest, I probably don't even have to put on the new one. It's actually in great condition. Just needs a little cleaning because this is made out of metal. And as long as you're careful, you can reuse them. So, want to reuse this? Reuse it? Okay. So, I'm going to ask my beautiful fiance to get my can of brake cleaner from the shed, please. It's in the can of brake cleaner that's in the shed. There'll be a... pretty clean with just a rag. So, stop this video and move on to the next. Before I do that, take my Chinese trusty paper scraper and just scrape this off a little bit. Edge on this metal is very sharp, so be careful. You should be wearing gloves. This is actually razor blade sharp right at the corner, so even if I just drag my hand across it, I could seriously just split open my hand. And mine's like, it doesn't look brand new, but this is actually got a really clean edge. Scrape it too bad and screw it up. You just want to scrape the gunk off of it, essentially. I would suggest a brand new utility razor blade, maybe, and extreme caution not to cut yourself. Whoa. Okay. Drag my knuckle across here, almost did it. Use dexterity with gloves, and I like to feel without gloves, so I do waive my right to safety in some certain cases. I'm just cleaning it off gently. I'm going to go ahead and clean this off. I'm
give you a little shot of what I'll be cleaning off with.
Got my oil pan.
Using my oil pan to clean this off and some brake cleaner. Pretty good now, and I'm gonna stop there and recontinue another video. So
see you guys in a little bit. As soon as I replace these two tires, oops.
Cover it. So, peace.